voy a dimitir. No voy a dimitir. No voy a dimitir.
Outrage over a kiss by the man at the top of Spanish soccer on the lips of a female soccer player in front of millions watching the World Cup has snowballed into a Me Too moment, building for years in a nation increasingly intolerant of abuse. Spanish Soccer Federation RFEF President Luis Rubiales' kiss of Jenni Hermoso not only soared the World Cup triumph but also triggered a torrent of allegations from other women in sport of predatory behavior by men. I think it's really similar to the Me Too moment. Veronica Boquete, who captained Spain at their first World Cup in 2015, said that she really think that it's going to help to the change because the change is already there. She said, adding the scandal was only tip of the iceberg.
I think it's really similar to the Me Too moment. I really think that it's gonna help to the change because the change is already there. It was already before this World Cup and this incident. We are in a moment of changing. And I think that this can push us as a society a little further and a little faster. And it's the part of the iceberg that you see, because everyone saw that, because it was on TV, it was in the highest stage of a World Cup. So obviously it's something that you pay attention, but there is a lot more, and it has been there for so many years, and maybe are smaller things or not that impactful or not that visual, but it shows that there is a system that it doesn't work well. So right now, with everything that happened, it's crazy that he is still there, because he provoked a feeling and a situation in the team, but also in the whole country, that is nowhere healthy and is not the best for performing the highest level. So I think that he did a good job. He could take that wing as his wing, because he was also there, and try to move on and let people work in a different way and accept that the people in Spain and the players in the team, they don't like him. They don't want to work for him or with him, and it's the time for a change, and I think it's gonna be the best for everyone.
The scandal has come after years of increasing disquiet in Spain over abuse of women, especially after the notorious 2016 Wolfpack gang rape of a teenager, which prompted to reform sexual consent laws. In the case of soccer, the women's team's effort to combat sexism and achieve parity with their male peers date back nearly a decade. That includes two dressing room rebellions that ended the international careers of several players. Boquete led a mutiny seeking the resignation of coach Ignacio Correa after a woeful performance at the 2015 World Cup. Things have changed a little bit. I can't say that everything is the same as it was 20 years ago, but we are not happy with the speed of that change, Boquete said when she was asked about Correa.
Es cierto que durante muchos años hemos tenido distintas guerras, más grandes, más pequeñas, pero siempre hemos intentado conseguir algún cambio porque creíamos que no estábamos respetadas ni valoradas a nivel profesional, pero tampoco a nivel personal por muchos de los comentarios o mucho del trato que recibíamos. Se ha cambiado un poco. No puedo decir que todo está igual que hace 20 años, porque no es cierto, pero no estamos contentas con la velocidad de ese cambio. Hay un momento donde los principios y los valores tienen que estar por encima de tu trabajo y, evidentemente, en ese momento esa no fue la realidad. Además de que ese speech viene después de que ya todos los acontecimientos sucediesen, si alguien no estaba de acuerdo ya se podría haber manifestado antes, eso tampoco sucedió, y luego las disculpas de después. con un comunicado de una manera muy fría, tanto por parte de Jorge Vilda como de la Fuente, donde lo único que demuestran es dejar a un lado al que hasta ahora ha sido su jefe, porque saben que probablemente no vuelva a ser su jefe, pero realmente no condenan ni se posicionan claramente del lado que se tendrían que posicionar. Lo que quiero decir con que es la punta del iceberg es que es lo único que se ha visto, pero hay mucho más. Cuando hay una reacción así, cuando hay una conducta así, cuando se hace un discurso de 30 minutos de la manera que se hace y todo lo que se dice en él y cómo se dice, quiere decir que el problema va mucho más allá que el de una persona o el de un acto en concreto. Y yo creo que aquí estamos hablando de un problema del sistema, de un problema cultural, de una manera de actuar y de hacer las cosas que quizás está demasiado normalizado dentro de esa federación, pero también dentro de otros sitios, porque este es un ejemplo de todo lo que tienen que vivir muchas mujeres en cualquier, dentro del deporte, pero en cualquier otra empresa también. Me ha sorprendido, creo que nos ha sorprendido a muchos en España y también a nivel internacional, porque el que sea un hecho grave y no muy grave envía un mensaje a la sociedad y envía el mensaje de que, bueno, puedes hacer algunas cosas, pero tampoco es tan grave y las consecuencias no van a ser tan graves. Lo que esperábamos es que el mensaje fuese distinto, que fuese mucho más contundente y que eso nos ayudase a frenar muchas otras conductas que suceden diariamente.
Players interviewed in a 2021 Movie Star Plus documentary Breaking the Silence described a culture of bullying under his tenure. Corrida resigned in 2015 in a statement issued by the Federation making no reference to the players' mutiny. He was replaced by the current coach Jorge Vilda. Vilda also cut from the squad several of the ringleaders who sought Corrida's removal, including Boquete, at a time widely viewed as the peak of her career. In September last year, 15 members of his squad also went on strike, demanding changes in working conditions such as physiotherapist and business class travel to ensure they were rested before games, standard conditions for men's national teams. Most of the players involved were cut out of the squad even as some demands were met. Vilda, who is facing possible sacking in coming days as part of the fallout from Rubiales' kiss, did not respond to a request comment sent to the RFEF. But after the mutiny last year, he told a November press conference that instead of false insinuations, any player should go public if they had not received untarnished treatment of impeccable respect from him.